Hi, Don and I want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. This year has been somewhat trying, but at the same time, the love and support that we felt from all the citizens of Tangipahoa has made this year phenomenal. We hope that all of you have a great year, and we look forward to 2023.
Ethan Dunn here in Husser. He's with the fire department and a lot of other organizations. He's the spark plug behind getting this old school, the community center, refurbished. The latest development there is obviously, as you can maybe see, a new roof is going up, courtesy of Pride Roofing. What an amazing story, because there was a time when it looked as though this building, not long ago, was going to be torn down.
You know, in 2019, when we really restarted this project, this has been long coming for many, many years. A lot of people were very skeptical whether or not we were going to be able to get this done. And, you know, really just this year alone in 2022, a lot of big stuff's happened for us. And this has really been, I would say, the best Christmas present that you could have imagined.
Well, one thing you've done is to get it recognized actually on the National Historic Register, which was a big step.
It was, and that was a long process. We started in January of 2020, and we got that recognition in December of the same year. A lot of time and effort went into that project.
Really amazing that over the years that hadn't been accomplished before.
No, and it was thought about many years ago, and you know, now with the availability of materials, both online and, of course, with that type of project, you rely a lot on people's firsthand experiences, interviews, that sort of thing. It was a little bit easier, I think, for me nowadays than it would have been 30 years ago.
So how did you get the new roof that's obviously going up?
So I work for the sheriff's office, and Jimmy Travis and I have been good friends for a long time. Jimmy was very aware of this project, and as I understand, Pride Roofing reached out to him and said, hey, we want to donate a roof to somebody for Christmas. And Jimmy, being very aware of what we've been trying to accomplish here, hooked me up with Alex, and it was pretty much an instantaneous yes from them.
You know, good timing too, because we've been dodging the rain, and who knows what kind of precipitation we'll get.
Well, you know, for the last probably 2 years, we've had a waterfall right inside the front door. Part of the old roof that had been rusted really bad was leaking. And when I say waterfall, you walk in and it was running down the wall. And this really is the most vital part of this whole restoration project.
What else will need to be done, though?
So after the roof is done, we are in a safe zone. Before we were able to do the roof, we had to fix the foundation. We were able to get that done on a donation basis as well. We only paid for materials. Next, we can really start focusing on, immediately following the roof, we're replacing all the window panes. A lot of window panes are broken. Some of them have been missing for quite a while. So we're waiting on those to come in and they'll be replaced. Beyond that, we are you know, looking at doing the interior stuff, trying to get the walls painted, a few spots in the floor needs to be replaced, stuff like that. But we're pretty close to being able to let people walk inside again.
So what do you hope to use this building for?
For a long time, it was rented out. People would use it for birthdays and weddings and baby showers and you name it. But believe it or not, what a lot of people beg us to bring back are the old bingos. Bingo was a big thing out here a long time ago, pretty regular. And I probably get that request more than anything. Hey, are y'all going to have bingo again? Well, I guess if that's the demand, we're going to have to do that. But any kind of event for the community.
Well, meanwhile, the fundraising campaign continues.
That's right. We've been able to raise a lot of money on just regular donations. You know, our fishing rodeo that we started back last year, we've incorporated a silent auction and like chicken dinner fundraisers. And so that's brought in a good bit of money. But recently we've actually been promoting our 100th anniversary commemorative coin. We had custom cut. Basically, it's the front of the school, and on the back of it, we've got a blurb about the history of the school. 100th anniversary, 1921 to 2021, little history about the school being built, how much it, you know, the fact that the community organization bought the school in 2 acres for $75 at high auction from the school board. And then each one of them are custom numbered 1 through 100. So we're selling those for $100 a piece. Basically, you give us a $100 donation, we give you a coin in return, and all that'll go into the restoration money.
Well, as if all this wasn't enough, I hear you're also working on getting as much as you can for the old auditorium in Loranger.
Actually, yeah. I was asked by the Alumni Association just a few months ago to head up that project, trying to have the auditorium added to the National Register. A lot of people think it already is a National Historic Site because of the marker that's out front. That was actually a project that the State Historic Preservation Department did many years ago with an effort to get people to do the full process, but that never happened. So, you know, after Ida, the damage that the auditorium received, predominantly in the roof, the school board really wants to take a big step in having it protected, and so that's where we're going to come in and make that happen.
What are the advantages to getting a place on that National Register?
Most importantly, protection. There's really not a whole lot of money that can come from that. A lot of active schools that are still in use have the potential to get some kind of grant funding, but the federal government doesn't give anything more than a tax write-off. But the protection alone, that you say, hey, this is a National Historic Site, you can't touch it, that speaks volume.
Well, and again, you know, how many people dropped the ball over the years on the Loranger Auditorium?
Again, another one of those projects that's been talked about and gone unseen. Like, that was, they did begin the process of having that one added as on the National Register quite a few years ago, and it, again, fizzled out.
People were up in arms recently when the old Hammond Feed and Seed store was torn down. And yet, it was never on any historic register, never any designation at all. It wasn't in the historic district, so there was nothing to do.
Right, and you know, and being in Loranger, same thing. Husser, same thing. You know, we're not on any main street. We're not part of any main street programs or historic districts. But you know, the driving force out here in the rural area really is the local history, the sentimental value is what the big driving force has been for here in Husser, and I know Loranger's the same way.
And you know, Husser has such a great history and such a sense of community. They used to joke that everybody in Husser is named Husser.
Yeah, well, you know, it's funny because, you know, the Hussers weren't the first settlers here. You know, one of the oldest families is actually the Bollingers right around the corner. They've been here much longer than the Hussers have been, you know, but the Husser family just kind of took over, and that's what we became known as.
Well, hopefully this building will be back in use pretty soon. Do you have a deadline?
My goal is that by the end of March, we have our third annual fishing rodeo scheduled for the last weekend of March. Our goal is to let people walk in the building during that fishing rodeo. Can't say we're going to have electricity anytime soon. I'd like to see electricity back, you know, this time next year, but we got a lot of little things to do between now and then. But you know, the roof being done first is the biggest step in this whole thing. We can do a lot of stuff now.
Well, it speaks volumes about your community, your efforts, and the fire department that you've made this much progress.
Yeah, you know, for a short period of time, the fire department actually took control of the community center from the community organization following Katrina. And from Hurricane Katrina, this entire side that's behind me was ripped off, and the fire department replaced that roof for the community center. And, you know, the two really do go hand in hand. You know, again, like you said, I've been in the fire department here for 15 years. I've only really been involved with the community center for, you know, the last 3 years. But a lot of the same people that were instrumental in getting the fire department up off the ground in 1968 were all the same people that were instrumental in having the community center continue for so long.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, we appreciate everybody's support. Look, we're really gung-ho about getting this building back in use, but I think the biggest thing for me is just getting the community involvement back to where it was. And even though we may not be able to use the building right away, we want to still be able to do things here and do things on the property. We have a lot of different plans down the pipe. We've even talked about doing some kind of winter gala to help support the restoration project to follow through to the end. We've got a lot of little things we want to see done in the long run, and it's probably going to take a few more years. So as much continued support as we can get, we'd appreciate it.
Great news. There's someone you can call for fast, reliable service on your air conditioning. American Cooling and Heating, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Friendly people who are experts at what they do. 25 years in business with lots of satisfied customers. Old-fashioned service, plus the wherewithal to get the job done right. American Cooling and Heating,